some crazy sex in here. Let's get out of here. Alright, let's take a look at this guy and see if we can't help him get out.
Can you hear me? It's not too late to set things right.
Right. How did we open these? I think we bash it with something? Maybe later. I know. Let's use a musical instrument. Where did I throw that? Oh, shoot. We don't need a musical instrument. This will do just fine. Oh. Break! Okay, that was useless. There's never a rock around when you need one or something. Was there a rock over in this direction? Plenty of cockroaches. Plenty of madness. Tennis racket. Oh. That's what that applause was for. Dude was a tennis racket duder.
How did you escape?
It's not the key either. I would tell you, but I'm a mute. Ah, friggin' lock. Just open. Okay, I don't know how to free this guy. Let's see if we can find something downstairs that might be able to help him. Won't budge. There we go. Oh, hey, there's that violin.
Have you seen Justine?
How do you know I'm not Justine? God damn it, son! That's no way to treat an expensive musical instrument! Okay, there's gotta be a friggin' way to get to this guy, or at least save him. Okay, no. Reach that? Just the person I need to talk to. Mr. Beryl. Okay, how about now?
Right. Can you hear me? It's not too late to set things right.
You already said that.
Help me. Please, help me!
Here, why don't I ask you a series of questions, and it'll help you get your mind off of things. Do you like bees? Alright. Come on. How hard is it to climb on top of this? There. Alright. That was mighty fun. Uh, Oh, yeah. Lots of joy here. How about we go away from the creepy scream thing? Oh. Okay, that's a little bit creepy. A little bit creepy. I'm only a little bit creeped out. Oh, yay. Dead end. Emphasis on the word dead? Hopefully not. Okay, I think I'm good here. Roaches are my friend. Oh, hey. That's good. This is good. This could be a good thing. Ow. Alright. What's up, man? There's no cylinder in the phonograph. I'll have to find one. Okay, boarded up. Why don't we check this room first? Because, I mean, that's where the blood leads, and you always want to go towards the blood, right? Huh. Alright, well,
congratulations for coming this far.
Thank you.
I'm so excited for you. I do hope you managed to save Monsieur Fournier. He was a friend. And a colleague of my papa, you know. Friendly fellow, a real bon garçon, but frail of mind. He puts up an impressive front, but it is all an act, I assure you. Please, go on. We are just getting started.
Honestly, this is what my dreams are like. Alright. We have a letter. Travesty at the conservatory. Many Parisians had gathered last night to enjoy the performance of violin virtuoso Malot de Frenchword. It was to be the grand premiere of several new arrangements of songs by fellow composer George Bizet, but the evening took an unexpected turn. Young Malot, etc., turned up visibly intoxicated. His violin cried as the bow was jerked across the strings. The audience seemed forgiving at first, but started to boo the man off stage as he defecated in the beloved song. I know, defaced, but that's not funny. Les Roses et Frenchword. The stress apparently got the best of the young musician as he threw his bow into the audience and finally collapsed. Mademoiselle Justine Florbel, who is, according to rumors, romantically involved with Monsieur Frenchword, looked quite amused by the event and had two of her friends, Basil Frenchword and Frenchword Rancine, carry him off the stage. The evening was saved by other musicians at the conservatory, who was able to perform a most delightful impromptu concerto in Malot de Frenchword's absence. The audience showered their saviors with praise and calls for encore, were awarded with spectacular pieces of both Offenbach and Chopin. Oh, and I keep on forgetting words. Rat, can I pick up Mr. Ratty? Can I pick up Mr. Ratty? Come here, Mr. Ratty. Fine. Didn't I see a violin back there earlier? What am I doing? All is good. My head is crystal clear. I got a useless lamp, and I'm using it right here. Libraries are pretty safe, right? The downstairs library still reminded her of Father, and those hours spent there fostered a sense of shelter. Whoa. meat.
On this next piece, you should be looking for some divine inspiration. Time to delve into your spiritual side. What do you see? Is the man begging for mercy, or is he being blessed? Perhaps both. Father used to say there were no right answers. Have the light to guide you.
Oh, not in there. Huh. Here we go. Ooh. I'ma stand this broom on its end. There we go. What was the name of that movie with Bruce Campbell about the red-headed girl at a girls' school that was, that could magically balance things? Slide one. Oh good, more reading. The tests have been going well. The most long-term, and in a sense the most promising one, is the light box. Having Justine choose a slide, essentially a mood, for every day is a great way to see the larger overall development of her mind. She definitely reads things into the slides I had not foreseen. Her remarkable imagination turns the characters into just about anything, and she is able to effortlessly reduce all her experiences into one of the four character slides. Using the puzzle lock has proven more difficult, as she tends to always choose two slides, which the character is facing the same way. I have asked her why this is, but she doesn't seem fully to understand what I am asking. Creepy. Hey, tinderbox!